Hi, this is Ryan with Video Conference Gear. Today I want to give you a demonstration of the Poly X50 Studio versus the Neat Bar for Zoom Rooms. So right now I am on the Neat Bar where my microphones are selected there, as well as you're seeing both cameras in this scenario. I'm going to get up and walk around this room, which is a 19-foot room in this scenario. So this gives you an idea of how these both of these devices do tracking with everyone on the with people in the room and people moving around. So this gives you an idea of how this fast they move adjusts to these different things. There are some additional settings in the background, but let's go through the differences of these devices. So right now I've been talking on the Neat Bar is where my audio pickup's been, but I'm gonna move over to the X50 to give you an idea of the different audio levels. So I'll mute over to the X50. So now you can hear a little bit of a difference in the audio side there. The Poly X50 has a built-in 4K camera with a 5x zoom and 120 degree field of view. The difference over on the Neat side is it has a 4x zoom camera along with the 4K and 120 degree field of view. I personally feel that 4x to 5x is negligible in the difference there. Poly touts having speaker tracking built into the camera, as well as auto framing and manual PTZ that we can adjust from the Zoom Room controllers. Jumping over to the Zoom Room controllers, this is where I feel Neat has done a much better job for some multi-purpose things with their Neat Pad, where I can actually move this into a scheduling display outside of conference rooms as well, but I am tied to that one platform within the side of Neat. The next part of the puzzle is, what is the mics and the pickup range? So the Poly touts having 3 built-in microphones with about a 25-foot pickup range, while Neat is saying they have 5 built-in with a 20-foot pickup range. So this room, I'm gonna move to the back, is 19 feet in depth. And this will give you another idea of how does the Poly X50 sound in comparison versus the Neat, where I moved around a little bit earlier to capture the different audio. Another part of the puzzle that looks good on both of these devices where they match up is their ability to run dual displays. This room that I'm in is a single display, but it's nice to have the dual displays. That's often needed in many places. Where I find the huge leg up for the Poly side is multiple platforms for future-proofing. So such as today, we're on a Zoom Room system, as well as you can down-boot it, as I call it, and move, after factory reset it, move it over to Microsoft Teams, RingCentral, or GoToRooms. Unfortunately, today, all the devices on the market required to do a factory reset to change platforms versus a simple switch of moving to the platform of your choice. The other part that is a benefit for Neat is the price and performance. So this one, the Neat Bar Pad, comes at $2,500, whereas the Poly X50 is $3,500. The Neat Bar is a nice device, but I think they're moving up. They have another bigger device coming pretty soon. They'll compete more on par with the X50. And I find the Neat Bar is right in between the Poly line of the X30 and X50 devices. So it's kind of right in that middle ground. So I'm excited to see the next version from Neat. But they are some nice devices. They give a simple, easy setup for your video conference rooms. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to call us at videoconferencegear.com. Thank you.